If we don't register, they'll throw us in jail. So we all have to do our part.
It is true. However, I must tell you that the journey is not always pleasant for those who choose to make it. Moving through the Dark Force dimension will show you what you fear.
Anyway, we've got stuff to do. Talk to you later.
Time getting a list together, or even a rough number, but it's probably in the dozens by now. And the media continue to do little to expose it. They're practically cheering it on. We need to stay focused on winning this thing, and that means swaying public opinion enough. Thanks. We need to have faith in the people.
Agent of Hydra. By now, you've sworn your death oath, and in a few moments, you will receive your very own Hydra Concussive Force Blaster. Now, please listen to this very special message from our esteemed leader, Baron Wolfgang von Strucker.
Hail Hydra! These are the words you'll say again and again as we relentlessly march on our noble quest for world dominance. I'll be listening for your voice, added to that of our countless brothers and sisters. Our victory chant, driving fear deep into the hearts of our enemies. Cut one head off to grow in its place.
Hail Hydra!
Top story, the FBI and S.H.I.E.L.D. have announced that the superhero Speedball of the infamous New Warriors was found barely alive last week in Western New York. Authorities have also released his true identity, Robert Robbie Baldwin, the 19-year-old son of Justin Baldwin, a Connecticut district attorney known for crusading against costume vigilantes. Baldwin was presumed to have died along with his teammates in Stamford. However, experts say he could have been protected from the deadly explosion by his unique kinetic energy absorbing abilities. The fact that he was thrown nearly 500 miles from Ground Zero is a testament to the force of that blast. With his powers apparently shorted out, Baldwin is now in government custody, awaiting trial. Inside sources say attorney Jennifer Walters, aka the She-Hulk, may be representing Baldwin and trying to negotiate a plea bargain for him. Welcome back. We're talking about the Superhuman Registration Act, and I see we have another caller. Hello, you're on All POV.
Hello, Terry. This is Captain America.
I Is this a joke?
No. I'm glad to hear that at least some news sources are giving both sides of this debate the chance to air their views.
Well, I... yes.
Listen, I can't talk long. I'm sure they're already trying to trace this. I wanted to say to your listeners, particularly those who have special abilities and haven't registered, you're not alone.
What advice would you give someone in such a situation, Captain?
There's not a lot I can say that won't compromise our position. But if you want to join us in the fight for your civil rights, watch for us. With any luck, you'll find us before they find you.
All prisoner calls are monitored by Rikers Island Penitentiary staff. You have 5 minutes.
Mr. Baldwin, is that you?
Yeah. Did you get the costume design?
Yes, but I had a question about it.
Make it fast. They don't give me much time on the phone.
Well, the insides of the suit are exactly as specified. The lesser spikes protrude just over half an inch. Painful, but hardly incapacitating. The, larger spikes will no doubt break the skin of the wearer. I cannot imagine any use for this other than torture.
Did you have a question or not?
Whomever this costume is intended for, you must hate them very much.
I do.
Who is it? I must know.
Me.
What? Why?
My powers have changed. They only work now when I'm in pain.
But this costume, it's sick. What I'm asking,
what I'm doing is penance. 612 people died at Stamford. So every day I'll carry with me 612 points of pain. The 60 children who died, those are the longer spikes. They'll hurt me the most.
You sure you don't just want another speedball costume?
I could. Speedball is dead. All that's left of me now is penance.